Good morning, good afternoon, and good evening to all. Thank you for joining us. It is my pleasure to welcome you to today's Frost and Sullivan Growth Opportunity Briefing, 6 Mega Growth Opportunities in Israel and UAE.
My question is, what are the key trends that you see from an economy ministry that will perceive the drive, will drive the future of growth in Israel? While we get Mr. Shail back to answer his question about UAE.
Yeah, so thank you very much, Manny. Thank you for Frost and Sullivan for this event and for all the panels and the viewers. I think that the Israeli government, for the last few years, you can see the way we are open the business sector and make it easy for multinational companies or for foreign investors to come and to invest in Israel. If I'm talking with all kinds of segments in the ease of doing business, taking down all kinds of barriers and obstacles in the Israeli bureaucracy and the regulations, we can talk about the ease or the tax benefits that Israel government is more and more bringing to the table for the investors or the private sector overall. And what I'm saying about the tax benefits, there is also grants and others that we are providing for those foreign investors. We can talk about salary subsidies, and we can talk about all kinds of grants for industries and the preferred areas in Israel, and even specific sectors that we are trying to make it lucrative for the world to see to come to Israel, not only for the technologies, but also for the capabilities of manufacturing here in Israel. And I'm sure that Ron will be known to tell about it even more about those capabilities here in the country. Even the establishment of my unit, Invest in Israel, in the government, in the Ministry of Economy, it's a saying for the world, we are here for you. You have our back wings, and we will help you throughout all the way in everything that you will need, and Israel is open for business. So the thing that I've said until now is trends that the Israeli government open the gates for the whole world. And even now we are starting to talk more and more about specific bridges with the UAE to know how, what is your needs and what our capabilities both ways, and to make sure how those bridges can make those gaps even smaller. And before that, we talked about specific sectors, and I know that there are also sectors that are very interesting in the UAE. For example, digital health. It's a specific sector that we are always opened new routes for investors and for the industry here in Israel. We can talk about life science, we can talk about cyber technologies, we can talk about technologies and industries in agri-tech and food tech. All of those things, there are sectors that the Israeli government is very pushing forwards, and I know that it's also interesting for the Emirates to open, and there are new sectors that are trying to go more and more deeper.